Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Pastor Gerrod here to share today's daily topic with you. Today, we're going to be looking into the book of Habakkuk. And I just want to encourage you to read the entire book. Now, it's really easy. It's only three chapters. But what we learn in Habakkuk is how to pray in our time of deepest need. And that's what Habakkuk is going to teach us today. I think this is great timing as we are continuing to face this pandemic. I think it's a great opportunity for us to turn to God in prayer. And so let me give you a little backdrop here. We're going to go through chapters 1, 2, and 3 pretty quickly. And so we start in chapter 1. Habakkuk is crying out to God. So he lives in Judah, and the Babylonians are invading, and what Habakkuk takes this opportunity to really challenge God, to go to God. He cries out to God, God, why is this happening? What's going on here, God? Where are you in all of this? Now, the Babylonians were evil people, wicked. They had no respect for humanity. And they are just going through Judah right now. And what's happening here is Habakkuk doesn't understand how evil can prosper. And he cries out to God and he goes, God, why are you allowing this to happen? He says, how long, O Lord, must I call for help, but you do not listen? And I think this is very connected to what the world is facing today during this pandemic. I think a lot of people throughout the world right now are going, God, why are you allowing this to happen? We might not be dealing with a war with evil people, but we are dealing with an evil virus. And not only about the virus, our whole economy has shut down. So what this also means is that people are struggling financially and they just do not understand how and why this is all happening. And we see this back several thousand years ago with Habakkuk. And so that's Habakkuk's response to God in the beginning is, I don't understand this, Lord. Why is this happening? Why aren't you listening to me? Why do you continue to have this happen? Now in verse 5, and then really all the way through chapter 2 of Habakkuk, God now responds. So let's look at God's response in verse 5. It says, the Lord said, look around at the nations, look and be amazed, for I am doing something in your own day, something you wouldn't believe even if someone told you about it. So here's God's response. He says, see, even in the midst of chaos, I am doing something amazing. And I'm working now, Habakkuk. I'm working now in your own day. And here's the thing, you might not understand, but my understanding surpasses all of your understanding. And I think that's important for us to know this today, that we're going to face things in life, whether it's war or whether it's a war on a virus, that we are just not going to completely understand. And God tells us in his word about this. And so that's how God first starts to respond to Habakkuk. But he goes on all the way through chapter 2. And what's happening here is God is establishing that he is God, that he is in control, that he is the almighty, all-powerful God, and we are not. And there are going to be things that he does because he has the understanding and the ability and the power to use evil people for his purpose to do really amazing things. That's how amazing God is. So I love this. So Habakkuk cries out to God. God responds. So Habakkuk goes to the watchtower and goes, now I'm going to wait upon the Lord and I'm going to hear from the Lord. So he hears from the Lord. And then in chapter 3, we look at his prayer now. And I think this is great because he went to the Lord, he heard from the Lord, and when we hear from the Lord, now we are getting equipped with God's word in a way that now equips us for life. And now we get to see Habakkuk's response in chapter 3. And we're going to focus on the beginning of the prayer and the end of the prayer. So let's look how it starts off in chapter 3. Habakkuk says, I have heard all about you, Lord. I am filled with awe by your amazing works. In this time of our deep need, help us again as you did in years gone by. So I love this. This is always a great way to start off prayer, with praising God. But I love Habakkuk here. He's not only just praising God for what's happening right now, he's looking backwards. He's looking back and saying, God, look what you did in my life. Look what you did in history. God, you remain faithful in your promises. You are a good God, and I celebrate that, and I worship that, and I give you praise for that. And now, contrast that. He's looking backward. Now let's go to the end of the prayer, where Habakkuk says this, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in the God of my salvation. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes me as sure-footed as a deer, able to tread upon the heights. And I just want you to see the contrast from chapter 1 into chapter 3 from the perspective of Habakkuk. Now he goes, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. And he's focusing on who? God of his salvation, that God saved him. And because he is now in a relationship with the Lord, he has what? God's strength. God's strength that does what? That keeps us sure-footed in the midst of adversity, in the midst of chaos in life. And I love that. Now that we have the sure-footedness of Christ in us, the power of God, now we have that stable, the stability to be able to handle these storms in life like a pandemic that we're facing now. And I want to encourage you to use the questions below to talk more about this, to read all three chapters in the book of Habakkuk, and really take some time in this coming week to spend some time praying and modeling your prayer just like Habakkuk. I hope you will join us tomorrow, same time, same place. Use the questions below to have a great conversation with your mentor or small group. Love you guys. God bless.